Are you an Amazon seller and want to automate your business and want to get out all the analytics and data and order data out of Amazon, but you're having a hard time doing so? Look no further. Amazon Seller Center was just published on make.com, which makes it super easy for you to automate it. And in this video, I'll show you some use cases of what you can do. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of techflow.ai and we love automation. In this video, I will show you how you can use the Amazon Seller Central modules on make.com to automate your Amazon business, your FBI business, if you are a seller. I will show you two examples and how you can set them up yourself, and then it's super easy to move forward. Let's jump into the very first example, watching new orders. So of course, Amazon, you're getting orders probably as a seller. You should be, otherwise do something else probably. And then you can get all the new orders. You can filter it by marketplace that you're connected to. For example, you can say only orders from the United Kingdom, and then you can select the order status, only the shipped orders, and then you can even select channels or payment methods. You can filter by buyer email or other values. But for this use case, we're just searching for shipped orders, and we also limit the total output to 5 at the very bottom. Of course, you can set that to a lot higher, like 100 or something, but I just want to demonstrate how this works. Then the next thing is to get the order line items of each order, because by default, Amazon doesn't show that. So we need to get them separately. And then what I'm doing here is I'm aggregating all the information back together into one single output, and then updating a Google Sheet with the whole order data at once. No matter how many orders I've watched here and how many line items I had, this will just consume one operation and will be super efficient. This is called bulk updating, and you can just review the settings over here and then you can replicate it yourself. Now going into the Google Sheet. In the Google Sheet, we have a simple overview of purchase date, buyer email, order ID, currency, order total, item price, item tax, item quantity, ASIN, seller SKU, promotion discount, order status, and the last update date of that order. And now let's just run it and see it in action. So it now output 5 orders in the watch new orders module here. Then it got the line items of each order. For example, the first order, there was just one line item. Second order was just one line item. And then it aggregated it all back together into one single operation and appended it all in one go to the Google Sheet. And here we go. So now we have all the data synced of that specific order, or these specific orders, and now we can continue to go and sync all orders out of the Amazon system into our own database. It can be a Google Sheet, it can be anything else that you need or that you're using to generate your reports, or that you want to further automate. If you want to review order IDs, if you want to track which items are working the best, and if you need the data outside of the system, outside of Amazon, then you can automate it that way. Now to keep it always updated, you can set a schedule and say, okay, at regular intervals, I want to check like every 20 minutes, every 30 minutes, every hour, every 2 hours, every day, if there are new orders. And if there are, then please sync them to our Google Sheet, and then it will do that automatically for you on the backend. That was the first use case. Let's jump into a second one, creating a report. With the Amazon app, you have the option to create all kinds of different reports for all kinds of different marketplaces. So you can select the marketplace you want to generate the report for, and then there are a bunch of different report types. And just select the one that you want to get out. For example, the coupon performance, the promotion performance, seller performance, and all these kind of different reports you can get out. Super powerful, and you can transfer them, sync them anywhere else and use them for your own purposes. Inventory event details, like you can check which inventory is still good, which one is overdue or something like that. And there is so much reports, so much data you can get out, basically anything you can generate on the front, and you can also get out automatically. Then you have to specify the promotion start date from and to. I can make it dynamic, so just adding add days now, and then minus 33 means it will start 33 days ago until 3 days ago, and then the data start time should also be the same, so I set it to the same value. and then generate the report. The next step is that you need to download the report document by simply using the document ID that you get from the previous module. And then it has also a short explanation here. You need to use the gunzip module from the archive app to decompress the file, and then use the parse.json module from the JSON app to use JSON data further in the scenario. So the gunzip, it's this one, you can find it down here. You can search for archive. I have already done that, so that's here. And then the gunzip, it's this module over here. And then just use the report document data as the input. And then for parse.json, you just use the data of the gunzip module as input. And then you're getting proper JSON out. And that will show us the coupons. And then I'll set up a filter. So only if coupons exist, are probably array length greater than 0. So only if there are actually any coupons available, coupons exist. Then I want to continue, otherwise I just want to stop. Then it would iterate the coupons and format them into a nice format that are readable or is readable for Google Sheets. And then I want to sync that to my Google Sheet with a coupon report, so coupon ID and all the other details of the coupons. And now let's run that once. The create a report module takes a while because on the backend it creates the report. And then it checks periodically, like every couple of seconds, if the report is already finished, because it's asynchronous. And that means it takes a couple of seconds before it's finished. And then only once it's finished in success, it will continue with the rest of your scenario. All right, so we have the report here. It downloads the report document, which is buffer, and then it decompresses it with the gunzip module and still looks like buffer, but the size is a lot bigger now. And then it parses the JSON to make it actually readable. And here we have all the coupon data out now. And since we have coupons, this filter matches. We are iterating it and then we're aggregating it again, so we can reformat it into the way we need it for the bulk updating at the end. And then ultimately, we are updating the Google Sheet with these settings. If you want to make a bulk update, just check the settings here and then pause the video and you can set it up for yourself. Saves a lot of operations. And here we go. So now we have everything synced here. We know which name, which currency, which start date, how much discount it gives, what the total discount was, how much redemption there have been, what our budget is, and how much budget we have actually spent. And hope this was helpful. And maybe one more thing to mention, there is the make an API call module for the Amazon Seller Central app, which means you can access now any kind of API call that the Amazon API offers, and there are a lot of them. So definitely check them out. And the biggest trouble that has been there in the Amazon authentication is not that easy to set up, but now Make will handle it all for you. So feel free to explore the API more and use all the API endpoints that are there, because it's very powerful and you can set up a lot of great automations with Make. Hope you like this video. Make sure to like and subscribe to get more of this content.